at this time to one of your marine biologist guides. Her name is Kaylin, and awaiting your arrival on the island quest to your other marine biologist today will be Nicole, and your captain today is Captain Dan. They are all there to guide and narrate your tour and answer any questions that you have, so by all means ask away. They have a lot of great information to share with you on this beautiful day.
Safety gear that we have first. So we are Coast Guard or Transport Canada regulated to tell you about our safety equipment. So these lovely things right here, these are our life vests. There's no front or back to these. If they were needed, they just get pulled on straight over your head. The long strings go around your back, back around the front, and tied securely in the front.
Thank you.
depending on the way that the light is hitting the water, how they blend right in sometimes. So definitely be seeing lots of those. Typically, it surfaces 3 to 4 times. At that point in time, it's inhaling and exhaling and exhaling and inhaling. And then it'll take a big breath and it'll dive deep. So it'll do a terminal dive. So it'll arch its back up high. It'll go straight down and it will be searching for its food source. But we're also going to listen for this whale. So you can actually hear the whale go.
Is water spout?
It's not a huge spout. Minke whales, which are the whales that we're looking for right here, they don't, the sun has to be at the right angle in order to see the spout. But it does clear off its blowhole, which is essentially what that spout is. Yeah, they'll come right up. So you can see those whales.
Oh, there it is.
And gonna surface again.
There it is again.
There's a good one.
Gonna surface again. That's not the last time. There it is again. Why isn't he? So baleen is what the whales have inside their mouth. They don't actually have any teeth. These guys use baleen, and that allows them to filter out the water. So they took that big gulp of water and fish. So what they're going to do now is they're going to use their tongue, and their tongue is going to push the water out through those baleen plates because there's a bunch of layers of them. There's only going to be fish left. They use it like a sieve almost. So the fish will get stuck in those baleen plates, and the water goes out through back into the ocean again because they're not drinking all of this water. And they'll use that big tongue of theirs to actually lick the fish off of these big baleen plates that are in their mouth. Now this stuff's been out of the whale's mouth for about 15 years now, so it's pretty hard. But it is made out of the same material that our hair and our fingernails are made out of. It's called keratin.
Oh, there they are! Here! I see them! Now these guys are all part of the same family. They're all echinoderms, so if you cut them in half, they don't look the same on both sides. And they're also part of the same family as the sand dollar. Now all these guys we did collect on the side of the wharf at low tide. And what's really interesting about these organisms is that they're all intertidal. They all have their own spot in layers along the shore. You'll see the kelps, or the urchins, and then the kelps, and the mussels, and the barnacles, and then the sea stars on top, which is really cool if you look next time at the shore. So the sea cucumber, you can see all its little ones.
Thanks for the ride.
Thank you.
Bye-bye.
See ya.